Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Welcome to our today's session. In our today's session, we are continuing to look at the topic nationalism and decolonization. So in our last session, we had looked at forms of decolonization, whereby we began looking at decolonization through peaceful means or constitutional means of decolonization. We focus on two African nations that were decolonized through peaceful means. We focus on Ghana and Tanganyika. And so today we are going to focus on the second form of decolonization, which is decolonization through armed struggle. So let's see. So what is the meaning of armed struggle? So armed struggle as a means of decolonization refers to a process whereby African nations were decolonized through armed struggle, whereby they use violent means of acquiring independence. And so examples of those violent means that were used to acquire independence, we have those examples such as they used violent demonstrations, they used violent strikes as a means of decolonizing African countries and hence forcing the European powers to grant African colonies independence. So we have examples of those African colonies that were decolonized through armed struggle. Example, we have Kenya, Mozambique, Zimbabwe, Guinea-Bissau, South Africa, Angola, Congo, among others. And so we find that most of those African colonies that were decolonized through armed struggle, most of them were Portuguese colonies. And so we are going to look at the Portuguese colonies that were decolonized through armed struggle. So we have examples of these Portuguese colonies. We have Angola, we have Mozambique, Zimbabwe, Guinea-Bissau. And so these colonies attained their independence through armed struggle. We find that we are going to focus now more on one of the colonies that were colonized, was colonized through armed struggle, and we are going to focus on one of the countries today, which is Mozambique. So we are going to focus on Mozambique. So Mozambique was a Portuguese colony, and we find that the nationalistic struggle in Mozambique began in the year 1920s. So we find that began when the Gremio African Association for Secondary Schools and African Association were formed. So it was formed with the purpose of ensuring that there was end to the aim at ending exploitation of African colonies. So they aimed at putting to an end exploitation of African colonies or Africans. So such exploitation had been going on especially in Mozambique, in the hands of Portuguese superpowers, whereby find that after establishing colony in Mozambique, then we find that the colonial government used exploitative ways of governing Mozambique. So some of these exploitative ways of colonial exploitation that they disputed, that the nationalists did not agree with, were such as forced labor. There were also heavily taxed. There was heavy taxation whereby the Africans in Mozambique were forced to pay taxation. And so these are some of the grievances that the Mozambique people did not agree with, and hence these were some of the reasons that made this association to be formed, the Gremio African Association for Secondary School. This was formed to end such colonial exploitation that they did not agree to. So looking at some of, besides that, we find that there are some of those political parties that were also formed with an aim of fighting colonial exploitation in Mozambique. So we find that the first political party that was formed was known as
National Democratic Union of Mozambique. So in short, it was known as UDENAMO. So UDENAMO was formed with an aim of also removing colonial exploitation, which was established by the Portuguese in Mozambique. And then the second party, which was also formed, was also known as Mozambique African National Union. So this Mozambique African National Union was formed in 1961. So it was formed by some of the Mozambicans or the people of Mozambique who had gone into exile. They were in exile in Kenya. They had run away from Mozambique because of the colonial rule, which was ruthless, and also because they wanted to arrest them, and so they went into exile in Kenya. So while in Kenya, they formed this political party known as Mozambique African National Union. So in short, it was known as MANU. So we are going to look at the third political party that was also formed. Third political party, which was formed also by the people of Mozambique, the nationalists in Mozambique, was also known as African Union of Independent Mozambique. So in short, known as UNAMI. So UNAMI was formed in Nyasaland, Congo, in 1961. So obeying the fact that they were also escaping from the ruthless colonial government, which was very cruel on the African nationalists, and so they were moving into exile. And so wherever they went there, the nationalists formed the party. So we find that this party, which was formed, it was formed in Nyasaland in 1961. And then we also have the fourth party that was also formed. This was formed in 1962. So this was also formed by a group of exiled Mozambicans who were in Tanganyika. Some of them were living in Dar es Salaam. So you find that Mozambican exile in Dar es Salaam formed a party known as Front for Liberation of Mozambique Movement. So Front of Liberation of Mozambique. So in short, this party was known as FRELIMO. This party was known as FRELIMO. So you find that by 1960, therefore, FRELIMO had started carrying out its activities with clear objectives. So you find that FRELIMO in 1960 was already controlling some of the parts of Mozambique, and therefore this really annoyed the colonial government, and therefore they wanted to retaliate. So how did they retaliate? They retaliated by assassinating the leader of FRELIMO. So the leader of FRELIMO who was assassinated here is known as Edward Mondlane. So Edward Mondlane was a leader of FRELIMO and was elected to lead the party towards independence and also towards resistance movement and seek freedom for the people of Mozambique. So we find that Edward Mondlane was therefore assassinated. Assassination means a person is killed because of political reason or because of political power. So we find that this therefore Edward Mondlane lost his life, was assassinated with a bomb in Dar es Salaam, that was in Tanganyika, where the party was formed. So we find that apart from being that after Mondlane had been assassinated, the party did not end there. So FRELIMO as a party also, they decided to choose the second leader who would spearhead or would ensure that the party's policies are continued with. So you find that they chose somebody known as that in 1970 they chose Samora Machel. So Samora Machel was elected. He was elected a new leader, was a leader of FRELIMO. So you find that Samora Machel also being very hardworking and a good leader of the party, therefore continue with the resistance movements to ensure that Mozambicans, the people of Mozambique, acquired independence. So we find that due to the activities of Frelimo, therefore, Mozambique on 15th June 1975, Mozambique became independent, and therefore they were free from colonial domination or colonial rule in Mozambique. And Samora, therefore, was elected as the first president, through armed struggle in Mozambique. So let's have a short break and continue after that.